Well, good morning and welcome to our worship on this Trinity Sunday. This is the 12th Sunday since we last worshipped in the St. Nicholas Church building. Hopefully within the next month or so, things may change. Today is yet another special Sunday in the life of the church, when we remember the wonderful mystery of our God, who has revealed himself to us as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Today, in our main Bible reading, we hear the commission of Jesus to his disciples to go out into all the world and to baptize in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And so this morning we begin our service with a great Trinitarian hymn. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning our songs shall rise to thee. The Son and of the Holy Spirit. God's grace, mercy, and peace be with you, and also with you. We have too often exchanged the worship of the living God for idols of our own imagining. As we gather to offer our praises to the holy and undivided Trinity, and to worship him in spirit and in truth, let us call to mind our sins.
We bow down and confess you are Lord in this place. We bow down and confess you are Lord in this place. You are all I need. It's your face I see in the presence of your life. We bow down, we bow down, we bow down and confess you are Lord in this place. We bow down and confess you are Lord in this place. You are all I need. It's your face I see in the presence of your light. We bow down, we bow down. Behold the man upon the cross, my sin upon his shoulders. Ashamed I hear my mocking voice, call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held him there, until it was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life. I know that it is finished.
So let us together confess our sin. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have wandered and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things that we ought to have done, and we have done those things that we ought not to have done, and there is no health in us. But you, O Lord, have mercy upon us sinners. Spare those who confess their faults. Restore those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to mankind in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may live a disciplined, righteous and godly life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. And the words of forgiveness. May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Today's special prayer. Let us pray. Holy God, faithful and unchanging, enlarge our minds with the knowledge of your truth, and draw us more deeply into the mystery of your love, that we may truly worship you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship your holy name. It's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever lay past and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. Worship your holy name. Your rich love and your slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before, oh, my soul, I worship your holy name. Yes, Lord. Time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore. Forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. silent, worship your holy name. Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never before. Worship your holy name, Jesus, I will worship your holy name, worship your holy
Majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in the heavens. Through the praise of children and infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is mankind that you are mindful of them? Human beings, that you care for them. You have made them a little lower than the angels and crowned them with glory and honor. You made them rulers over the works of your hands. You put everything under their feet. All flocks and herds and the animals of the wild, the birds in the sky and the fish in the sea, all that swim the paths of the seas. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
Blessing and honor, glory and power, be unto the Ancient of Days. From every nation, all of creation, bow before the Ancient of Days. Thank you.
a reading from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 28, verses 16 to 20. The Great Commission. Then the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age." Let us wait upon the Lord, in whose word is our hope.
Today, Trinity Sunday, is a day of invitation, a day to celebrate relationships, a time to hear and respond. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded. Go, therefore, and make disciples." A clear calling from Jesus through his Father and their Spirit. So what do we hear Jesus say, and how do we respond? Those two questions are core to our life as Christians, and they are core to our life as reconcilers. What do we hear the other say? And what do we say back? That is the heart of reconciliation. And of course, conflict. That is the heart of forgiving and being forgiven. That is the heart of relationships and why they break down. Whether that is between me and God or you and God, Matthew tells us, when they saw Jesus, they worshipped him, but some doubted. What do we hear Jesus say, and how do we respond? Whether that is between me and you, us and them, in the church, in our homes, schools, communities, nations, the earth, what do we hear Jesus say, and how do we respond? Matthew shows the disciples as being given authority to bear this calling. Not because of who they are, but because Jesus has called them, because of their response to this vocation to baptize in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, their vocation to love one another, to forgive and be forgiven, to love their enemies, to model relationships as friends, as forgivers and reconcilers. And of course, we are invited to hear this invitation too, through Jesus' life and death and resurrection, through the sending of the Spirit, through the forgiveness of the Father. And as we know, this is not an easy calling. It involves repentance, justice, truth, as well as love, grace, and hope. This calling must be at the heart of our relationships, as it is at the heart of the Trinity. This calling, this invitation from Jesus, is something we may hear differently. After all, we are all made in the image of God, but we are not all the same. Straight or gay, Jew or Greek, man or woman, powerful or powerless, black or white, slave or free. How I hear this invitation is not necessarily the same as how you hear it. That is not the point. The point is, do we hear this awesome invitation? And then, how do we respond? And as our listening, our hearing, our understanding of this invitation from Jesus will not be exactly the same, nor will our response be. Some of us are called to be teachers, some prophets, some healers, according to Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. But we are all called to be reconcilers, because that is what the model of God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit teaches us. This being together is a model of good relationship, of love and forgiveness and grace, of responding to this wonderful invitation to dwell in this Godhead of forgiveness and reconciliation. And this model is for all people, those who we agree with and those who we don't. But of course, this must not be a binary setup, right or left, gay or straight, right or wrong. The model of the Trinity has three relationships at its heart: a giving and receiving, which is not polarized or polarizing. That space of the Trinity is the space of reconciliation, the space where hurts and injustices can be brought and heard, where responses of love and mercy and forgiveness can be sought and given. When we return to our church building, we have already recognised that a lot of things will and need to change. We certainly won't agree with each other all the time as we think and discuss and pray our way forward within our community. But we should start thinking now. What does healing the wounds of history, living with difference, and building a culture of peace mean today in 2020? What do they mean for us here at St. Nicholas's? What do they mean for each of us who hear and respond to this call from Jesus in our differing ways, with our differing gifts, responsibilities, and contexts? Being in relationship is not about being the same. It is about understanding the other better, about being formed together into hope, about enacting and embodying the Trinitarian dance of love and mercy and grace. This relational way of being that is modelled for us in the Trinity is why, rather than demonstrating and counter-demonstrating, rather than descending into the "you're wrong and I'm right" binary mode of being we see so much in the way of thinking in politics, theology, and many spheres of influence today, we must find another way of living with difference, of celebrating diversity that is God's creation. This call to be reconcilers is our charism. Here in this space of suffering and rebuilding, our gift from God and to Him, our gift to ourselves and to the other. We here can provide a different response to the current worldview of the binary treatment of difference. We can provide a space which is safe enough for people to gather, to hear this invitation from Jesus in this way, and to best respond to it with their particular gifts. The concept of safe space is not what the Trinity means. No space is or can be entirely safe. We have seen that in recent years in the attacks in Manchester, London, Syria, and all over the world. But in our response to these events, we here can respond with a space which is faith-filled, faithful and just, a space to hear and to listen, to forgive and be forgiven. That is our gift. Let us share it, and let us take our place seriously, because nothing else seems to be working in this uncertain world. We have an offering which is born out of our calling to be reconcilers. That is how we can respond to Jesus' great call. That is how we can be disciples and enable others to join us. With both humility and the authority that we are given, let us go forth and share this wonderful space we have with the world. Amen.
The call of the kingdom, lift your eyes to the King. Let His song arise within you as a fragrant offering of how God, rich in mercy, came in Christ to redeem all who trust in His unfailing grace. The call of the kingdom to be children of the light, with the mercy of heaven, the humility of Christ, walking justly before Him, loving all that is right, that the life of Christ may shine through us. The cross, bringing peace and forgiveness and a hope yet to come. Let the nations put their trust in Him. King of heaven, we will answer the call. We will follow, bringing hope to the
us come before our loving God in prayer. O God of steadfast love, you lead us and teach us with gentle strength, urging and encouraging us to live lives worthy of you. Accept our prayers on behalf of your creation and gather all people into your presence as we pray. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. God's mercy endures forever. You have called your church into the leadership of service. Inspire our generosity of word and deed, that we may join in your work of reconciliation on behalf of the whole world. And today we pray especially for reconciliation in the United States, as we remember the events of the cold-blooded murder of George Floyd, be in that situation, Lord, and bring peace. Help us to overcome racism. Give thanks to the Lord, for God is good. God's mercy endures forever. You humble the exalted and exalt the humble among the nations of the world. Be with our leaders and all in authority, that they may exercise their power in a spirit of service and for compassion's sake. We pray for peace in our broken world. Give thanks to the Lord, for God is good. God's mercy endures forever. You lift the burden of those who suffer and guide those who wander in desert waters. Hear your children when they cry out to you in their trouble, and deliver them from their distress. We pray for all who have been caught up in the coronavirus pandemic, for those who mourn the loss of loved ones, for those in hospital. Be with them, Lord, and touch them. Give thanks to the Lord, for God is good. God's mercy endures forever. You have led us to this good town where we might dwell. Lead us as you led Moses and Joshua to create a peaceful and fruitful community. Give thanks to the Lord, for God is good. God's mercy endures forever. You bless the servant leadership of this congregation. Grant us vision and generosity as we respond to your calling with grateful hearts. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. God's mercy endures forever. You hear us, hear the prayers of all who are burdened. Accept our prayers on behalf of those for whom we intercede, especially this morning for Hillary, for Fliss, for Maggie, for Maureen, for Ron and June, for Brenda, for Leslie, for Ava, for Clive, for Albert and Alan, and for all on our prayer board. You bring us into your eternal land of promise. Those who have died, we remember especially, all in this community who have died and whose families mourn their loss. Give thanks to the Lord, for God is good. God's mercy endures forever. Lead us, O God, into your paths of faithfulness, that we may follow in the way of our Saviour Jesus, and live always within the power of your Holy Spirit. Amen. We draw our prayers together by saying the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
O Lord our God, how majestic is your name. The earth is filled with your glory. O Lord our God, you are robed in majesty. You've set your glory above the heavens.
We will magnify, we will magnify the Lord enthroned in Zion. We will magnify, we will magnify.
So let's seek God's blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious to you and grant you his peace and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Our final hymn is, O Church, arise and put your armour on. Hear the call of Christ our Captain.
Say that they are strong in the strength that God has given, with shield of faith and belt of truth, we'll stand against the devil's lies, an army bold whose battle cry is love, reaching out to those in darkness. To rage against the captor, and with the sword that makes the wounded whole, we will fight with faith and valor. When faced with trials on every side, we know the outcome is secure, and Christ will have the price for which he died, an inheritance of nations. Yeah.
so strengthened for the journey. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.
Words of my faith handed